Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ, and we are finally here for the last game of the season, so make sure you hit that like button. We are going up against Fresno State, and they are ranked number 21 in the country. And to add to that, they are also a rival of ours, so another rivalry game. And we've had two so far. We've played against two ranked teams so far this year, so this is our third ranked team, and we have a chance to go 3-0 in rivalry games and 3-0 versus ranked teams. So we do have three visiting prospects. You can see them there. And then before hopping into this gameplay, we are giving the players of the game their boost in awareness. Trey Walker on the offensive side gets one, and then Isaac Taguia, the true freshman, gets one on the defensive side. So let's hop into this action. We are at home, so it is senior day, the last time the seniors step out onto this home field. So here is Montel Aaron from the shotgun to start this game out on a 2nd and 8, throwing the ball deep, and that's caught by Bailey Gaither, 42 yards. He's a junior. He's going to be back next season, but that's a great start to this game. So now on a 2nd and 7, rolling out to the right side. Here is Montel Aaron picking up a big gain. He's going to fumble it, but it's luckily going to fall out of bounds, and we luck out as we get to about the 15-yard line. So here's Malik Roberson on the next play, getting a 5-yard carry up the middle to make it a 2nd and 5 at about the 12. So now 2nd and 5, clean pocket, throwing across the middle. It's Bailey Gaither again, and that's 2 passes, 2 completions, and a touchdown. And that drive seemed a little bit too easy as we take the 7-0 lead early on in this game. So here comes Fresno State out onto the field as they have kind of a balanced attack here, but their quarterback is more of a scrambler. Marcus McMarion, he's a senior as well, and you know he's got mobility. He can run 82 speed. He can throw as well. And they do have Jordan Mims, the sophomore running back, so we're going to be seeing him in the future. But McMarion, this is his last game in the regular season as a senior, so it's a big game for him. But on a 3rd and 8, here he is throwing the ball away right away. Seemed like he could have waited in the pocket a little bit more, but he threw it away and they punt it back to us. But here's Malik Roberson on the next drive, taking a big hit right away as we now get it to a 3rd and 10. So now Montel Aaron from the shotgun throwing the ball across the middle. There is Trey Walker, and he's going to make his way for the first down. And Trey Walker, the true sophomore, filling in for Ty Cottrell, who is out 1 more week. So he's going to be back for the bowl game as we won last week and we got bowl eligibility. And there's Josh Oliver picking up a gain of 21. So now on a 1st and 10. At about the 25-yard line, throwing the ball across the middle, and it's Trey Walker again. He is a catching machine as well. Remember last game, he had 11 catches for over 100 yards. Here he is getting open across the middle again and getting in for the touchdown, making it a 14-0 lead. There's never been a time when we actually had a 14-0 lead in this season at all. So this is actually foreign territory, playing with the lead. So now up 14, here is Fresno State throwing the ball deep, and there's Zamor Ziegler on the interception. And Zamor Ziegler is, he's kind of a weird guy, I'd say, at cornerback, because I mean, he's a junior, he's got 1 more year left, but he's like a boom or bust guy at cornerback. He's either giving up a big play or making a big play, and that time he makes the big play. So now here, getting the ball back, up 14 points, and giving the ball to Malik Roberson for 4 yards up the middle, and that's a 1st down. So now on a 1st and 10, giving the ball to Roberson once again, and he's having a hole up the middle, and that's nice blocking by our center and guard up the middle, and that's a 1st down. So now 2nd and 12, here's Montel Aaron scrambling out to the right side, going to throw across the middle, and that's Rashad Johnson, the senior, and he picks up 16 yards. So now we're past the 50-yard line here, running slants, throwing out to the flats, though. That's Josh Oliver there for the catch and run, gain of 18 as Montel Aaron finds his favorite target for another 1st down. So here's Montel, Malik Roberson getting the 6-yard carry to the right side, and we get it down to a 3rd and 4. So here's Montel Aaron this time throwing out to the right side. That's the senior Trey Hartley, as these seniors are getting involved quite a bit as he gets a 1st down. So now a couple of plays later, under center here on a 3rd and goal. Scrambling out to the right side, but he's going to get tripped up. Loss of 9. He's going to take the sack, and we're going to have to settle for the field goal. But that's still 17-0, as this has been our biggest lead so far this season. So now here's Jordan Mims trying to get going in the rushing attack for Fresno State, and they just cannot get going. So now 4 minutes left in the second quarter, 3rd and 10, running a screen pass, and here is Mims, and they just haven't been able to get any offense. I don't know if this is bad offense or good defense, but McMarion only has 7 yards passing, and they punt the ball away to us. But on the first play of the next possession, throwing the ball deep, and that one is picked off by Hughes, the safety, and we make our first mistake of the game going big. And it was kind of two routes ran in the same area, and it kind of threw Josh Oliver off of his route. It made us wait a little bit longer to throw that ball, and we threw the pick. But we do come back out on defense and have been able to stop McMarion up to this point. So I have the confidence in our defense. So now on a 3rd and 10, throwing the ball across the middle. There's McMarion finally getting his first down and finds Justin Allen for 23 yards across the middle. So now 1st and 10 at about the 30-yard line, throwing the ball to the left side, and that's Delvin Hardaway for 6 yards on the left sideline. So now 3rd and 5. Here's McMarion once again from the shotgun, scrambling out to the right side. Going to break a tackle but not get away from Jesse Ozuna as they get it down to a 4th and 4 and do settle for 3. So now we're up 14 here as we have under 2 minutes left in the half, trying to get some points on the board. We're going to try to put together a 2-minute drill as Trey Walker gets open on the out route, gain of 9. So now 2nd and 1. Here's Malik Roberson getting the handoff up the middle, and that's a gain of 3 as we're now down to under a minute in this first half. So now on a play action fake, trying to run that same play we ran earlier for the touchdown opposite side, but this time we do get the intentional grounding call called on us as we didn't want to take the sack. So now 2nd and 22. Here is Josh Oliver getting another catch across the middle, and the senior tight end picks up 21 yards as he's up to 60 yards off of 3 receptions already in this first half. So now here's Montel Aaron rolling out to the right, dumping it off to Oliver for 2 yards, and that's enough for a 1st down and enough to stop the clock. So now we get it to a 2nd and 9 here, not moving the ball much, but getting the ball out of bounds on this throw as we get it to a 3rd and 9. So 30 seconds left in this half. Rolling out to the right side, here's Montel Aaron unloading here, and that's going to be tipped as Trey Walker wasn't ready for that one. He actually probably had a 1st down, but that one's going to be knocked down as we don't get any more points going into half. But this was a solid half for our offense and our defense, man, 17-3. So coming back out in this second half, we've been able to shut down their offense, so we definitely want to carry that into the second half. So here is Mims finally getting a big run on this one, gain of 15, as that's his longest run so far. So now under center here is McMarion. He's going to use his stiff arm and get to the outside, and that time he's avoiding Ethan Aguayo and picking up a gain of 27 as they're now inside a field goal range. I mean, pretty good run by the quarterback that time. So now on a 1st and 10 at the 33-yard line, here is McMarion under center this time, going to scramble out to the right side, going to avoid a tackle that time and get up for another 1st down, 14 yards as he moves the chains. So now 2nd and 6, here's McMarion, delayed handoff to Mims, and Mims is getting inside the 5. So they've been able to run the ball successfully as we haven't even given up any big passing plays. It's just been all on the ground. So here's McMarion scrambling to the right side this time, and another open hole to the right side. And he's going to pick up 4 yards for the touchdown as they trim this lead back to 7. So now on the ensuing kickoff, here's Tyler Nevins to replace Ty Cottrell deep for this kick return. And he's going to return this one past the 50. So he's going to set us up with pretty good field position to start this next drive. So here's Malik Roberson getting a handoff here on a 2nd and 7 and picking up 11 yards up the middle as he picks up a 1st down close to the 35-yard line. So here is Montel Aaron on the play action, rolling out to the right. Going to avoid a tackler on that one and get it out to Trey Hartley, the senior, for 21 yards and a first down. So now second and 10. Here's Trey Walker. He's not as fast as Ty Cottrell, but he can still move with the ball a little bit. He picks up a gain of 3. So now third and 7. Throwing a ball across the middle, and here's Trey Hartley trying to fight for the first, but he only picks up 7 as we do line up to go for it on a fourth and inches. So under center, here is Francois Sims the second. He's going to get a carry up the middle. He's going to fight his way in. And the fullback, Francois Sims. I've never used a fullback as much as I've used him, but he's had a pretty good year, and I like his production from the fullback position. So now we're up 24-10 as Fresno State comes back out onto the field as McMarion tries to scramble out on the second and 5, and he gets swallowed up by Ethan Aguayo there for a sack and making it a 3rd and 8. So here's McMarion from the shotgun. I'm going to throw out to the left side, but that's not going to be to the sticks as Quick cannot stay in bounds and get upfield, and they punt the ball once again. So here's Montel Aaron this time facing some pressure up the middle and dumping it across the middle to Malik Roberson, the senior, for 4 yards. So now this third quarter is winding down here, throwing the ball across the middle. There's Trey Hartley again, and he's been getting involved so far in this game, and he picks up a first down. So now close to the 50-yard line, here's Malik Roberson as this third quarter winds down. He's picking up 10 yards on that carry, as it seems like he's had a pretty good yard, six yards per carry so far in this game. So now on a 1st and 10, here's Bailey Gaither, who had a pretty good first quarter. He gets going on that catch, and man, Montel Aaron is just showing up today as all his throws have been right on the money. So now here's Trey Walker getting the end around, breaking a tackle, only picking up 7, but you can just see the potential that he has in this slot position. I'm really liking what I'm seeing. So now on a 2nd and 3 here to start the fourth quarter, there's a quick throw to Josh Oliver, and he's up to 74 yards receiving as well. So now Malik Roberson from the shotgun, 1st and goal. Handoff to the right side. He's going to break away, and he's going to get in for the touchdown as nobody's there to stop him on the outside. And he uses that good speed. He's 5'8", and I'm really going to miss him come next season because he definitely is a guy that I expected Tyler Nevins to be the starter, but Malik Roberson definitely took over that position, and he's been having a great year. So now here comes Fresno State back out onto the field, and here is Quick getting a quick pass across the middle, and he's getting whipped around, and he's getting past the 50-yard line. So here's McMarion from under center, going to throw out to the right side this time, finding his tight end Rice, and he's picking up 10 yards. So they're starting to move the ball a little bit on this drive, but still down 3 scores. Here's McMarion facing some pressure by Owen Roberts. He's getting rid of that pass, and that's going to make it a 3rd and inches. So now here is McMarion from the pistol formation. Going to drop back to pass. He's going to try to run this one, but another sack by Ethan Aguayo. And that's his 2nd sack of the game. And look at Caleb Oaks. Almost there for the sack. I wish he would have got that sack, but hey, he's going to have a pretty good junior season as he comes back next season. So now here's McMarion scrambling out to the right side on a 4th and 1, and he's going to pick this one up, as we did have the spy on, but he still got outside of it, and this drive does continue. So now 4.5 minutes left in this fourth quarter. Here he is running out to the right side, and that's the only way he's been able to move the ball, just scrambling, as he picks up a gain of 6. So now 3rd and inches thrown out to the left side, and that's a nice diving stop by Trey Webb, the sophomore safety, as wow, is he everywhere on the field. So now they have another 4th and inches, and this time getting it out to Rice for another 4th down conversion, their 2nd one of this drive, as this drive does continue. So now under center here on a 2nd and 6, giving the ball off to Mims, and Mims is going to pick up a gain of 5, moving the ball inside the 5-yard line. So now 3rd and inches. Here's McMarion from the shotgun, going to throw out to the right side. That's going to be tipped and almost picked off by Dakari Monroe, and we force him to a 4th and inches. So now from the pistol, is he going to scramble this time? No, he's going to throw across the middle. That one's not going to be completed. And Trey Jefferson, we drop him back in coverage, and he probably didn't expect to see him there. And that throw was way off. I don't know where he was throwing that one, but we get the turnover with under 3 minutes left in this game. So we do put in our backup offense here. We don't really get to do this at all, so I wanted to show you guys what it looks like a little bit with Josh Levitt quarterback, as he's a mobile guy, as it's kind of a different offense I like to run with him because, you know, Montel Aaron's more the accurate quarterback and Josh loves the mobile one. So I want to show you what it looks like with him in the game. So here's Billy Humphreys, the backup tight end, who might actually compete for some playing time come next year, because I think there's going to be a three-way competition for tight end with Junior Fioka, the freshman, Billy Humphreys, who's going to be a junior come next year, and then also Matt Pollard, who I expect to be a tight end, who we did get to commit to our school from Colorado. So here's Austin Lyles, actually listed as the sixth-string receiver on our roster. He's a sophomore as well. He gets a gain of six. That's his first real playing time and first real yardage of this whole season. So here's Billy Humphreys getting another 20-yard reception. You could just see, like, in this offense, the tight ends benefit so much, and it's going to be a treat to see kind of a dual tight end kind of look next year, because that's what I plan on doing. But you see we did throw the interception there in garbage time, just trying to throw it up that time, see what we can do. But it doesn't matter. We do get the victory in this game. Trey Walker had a good game. Bailey Gaither had a pretty good game. And we do have some good news after that win. 3-0 versus ranked teams and three commits for San Jose State. It's Michael Bailey, Clarence Grant, and then a big defensive end who we wanted, especially stopping this run. I'm pretty sure he's going to be a pretty good addition to our squad. So this was actually a pretty good game. Besides that one interception by Montel Aaron, I would say this game was pretty much flawless and probably our best game, because we won by our biggest margin of the season, and it was versus ranked number 21 Fresno State. Not only was it a ranked game, but we'll also get some respect because we won versus one of our rivals. So we go to 3-0 versus rivals this season and 3-0 versus ranked teams. That's a pretty good season. This is probably the best season one that I've had in any of my dynasties, and this team is just a treat. It's just fun because, you know, we have a lot of seniors on offense graduating for senior day, but we also have some juniors returning on defense who are going to make an impact come next year, a big one, especially when we need to build this defensive lineup a little bit. Our secondary is going to look a lot different next year, but our linebacking core is going to look pretty much the same, because Ethan Aguayo, Isaac Taguia, and Jesse Ozuna are all going to be returning. I'm not sure if Jesse Ozuna is going to hold down that spot next year, but we'll see his competition, and I want to see, you know, we have some other linebackers that have just been sitting back and waiting, and we'll see what they do as well. But this was a good victory at home, 21-point victory. I mean, we haven't said that ever, and this is, I mean, amazing defensive game. We only gave up 200 yards of offense from Fresno State. I mean, that's a win in its own right. So hit subscribe, hit that like button. We're heading into bowl season and then the off season. So next, you don't want to miss the bowl game. I don't know who we're going to play yet. So stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.